Lord, we're together. This is Clear Vision Television Program, and I'm Rose, and I'm so happy to have you with me today. I'm so thankful to be able to come into your home by way of TV, by way of internet, by way of mail, by way of teaching, by way of telephone, any way that you allow me. Stay with me today. We're going to talk about how do you talk to God, because it's important what you say to God, and it's important what you say to yourself, and it's important what you say to other people. So stay with me. I'll be right back, and we'll get together and find out how to talk to God today the way He wants us to talk, in the name of Jesus. I love you, and I'll see you in a minute.
It's a little book with a big message. Stop Talking Crazy, Talk Love will teach you to use the power of your tongue with God's Word and watch your life stay in overflow. Order your copy today for a donation of any amount. And don't forget to request our free newsletter. Write to Rose Ministries, P.O. Box M, Bergen, Kentucky, 40310. That's Rose Ministries, P.O. Box M, Bergen, Kentucky, 40310. Or you can call us at area code 859-748-9961. That's 859-748-9961. Be sure to order your copy of Stop Talking Crazy, Talk Love, which teaches you to use the power of your tongue with God's Word to watch your life stay in overflow. Order your copy for a donation of any amount. Order your copy today.
Praise the Lord. We are so happy to be together today. I'm happy to be with you today because I get to encourage you and lift you up in the Lord, in the Word of God. And we're talking about how do you talk to God? See, everybody, I get phone calls at the ministry, and I love to talk with people. I love to hear what they have to say. But so often I get these phone calls, and everybody wants to tell me all about their life from back in the beginning of the womb, almost, it seems like sometimes. They want to tell me how many times their husband did this wrong, how many times their child did this wrong, how many friends did this wrong, or how many circumstances. And we need to go over that a little bit. But honey, when you're going to talk to God about this, He already knows about all that. Okay, so we've got a little book we're offering this time. We've offered it before, and I want you to donate for it. I want you to let the Lord bless you by sowing a seed into this ministry and ordering this book called Stop Talking Crazy, Talk Love. See, Stop Talking Crazy. That's what the Lord told me when we started talking, He and I started talking about how does He want me to talk? How does God want you to talk? Well, it says in Proverbs 18:21 and 6, verse 1 through 2, that death and life are in the power of the tongue, and they who indulge in it shall eat the fruit of it. For death or life, you are snared with the words of your mouth. All right, let's look at Jabez and see how he talked to God in 1 Chronicles 4:10. Now Jabez called on the God of Israel, saying, "Oh, that you would bless me indeed and enlarge my border, and that your hand might be with me, and that you would keep me from harm, that it may not pain me." And God granted him what he requested. When you're hungry, people give you food. When you're tired and you want to rest, you rest. When you need something, you ask someone who cares about you, and they'll meet your need. If you're living with someone who's not like that, then honey, I'm going to tell you today, you don't have to. You don't have to live like that. I'll just put it in plain English. In the mountains of eastern Kentucky, we say, if it isn't working, get away from it. Change it. If what you're doing isn't working, change it. Now, God wants you to talk the way He wants you to talk to Him. And He has a full awareness that you have emotions. He knows that you have thoughts. He knows that you have a mind. He gave you all of that. So what He wants you to do is use your mind in the skill, wisdom, and understanding that He gave you and talk to Him the way He wants you to talk to Him. And Jabez talked to God the way God wanted him to. He asked God to bless him. How many times have you asked God to bless you versus sitting and screaming at God because he isn't doing what you say. I know what it is to do this because I've yelled at God. We call it crying out to God, but it's yelling. It's yelling at the Lord. Yelling at him about why this isn't happening or why that isn't happening or when's he going to take care of this or why hasn't he taken care of that or why did he let this happen or why is he letting that happen? That's not talking to God. That's crazy talk. That's talking crazy. And God has decided long time ago that even though he knows you're going to talk like that and he hears that, he can't respond to it. God wants you to talk to him the way he wants you to talk to him. Job 10:12 says, "You, God, have granted me life and favor." See, Job had lost so much. And we don't have time today to get into that part of the teaching of how that all happened. But God came to Job in the last chapter of the book of Job, in chapter 40 and 42. And God asked Job, the Lord said to Job, "Shall he who would find fault with the Almighty contend with him? He who disputes with God, let him answer it." Are you disputing with the Lord when you talk to him? Are you disagreeing with him? Are you telling him you're not worthy to be blessed? Are you telling him you don't think you deserve him, his love, his grace, his mercy? Are you telling him that he shouldn't do this or that for you and he should do this and that for you? Then Job replied to the Lord, "Behold, I am of small account and vile. What shall I answer you? I lay my hand upon my mouth." It would do all of us well to lay our hands upon our mouth sometimes because we end up saying some things that we have no business saying. They don't agree with God. They don't agree with God's word. And they sure don't help anything or anybody. So when you take a minute today, I want you to get this little book, Stop Talking Crazy, Talk Love, because it's going to change how you talk. How you talk is going to be what you get. Now, a lot of people don't want to hear that because they don't want to take the responsibility that what you say is what you'll have. So I have to ask you right now, are you saying what you have, or are you saying what you want to have? See, when we talk about being scared to death, or sick as a dog, or broke as a skunk, or hindered in any way, that's not how God wants us to talk. God wants you to talk the way he wants you to talk. I'll be back in just a minute. Stay with me, and we're going to talk more about how God wants you to talk to him. I love you.
It's a little book with a big message. Stop Talking Crazy, Talk Love will teach you to use the power of your tongue with God's word and watch your life stay in overflow. Order your copy today for a donation of any amount. And don't forget to request our free newsletter. Write to Rose Ministries, P.O. Box M, Bergen, Kentucky, 40310. That's Rose Ministries, P.O. Box M, Bergen, Kentucky, 40310. Or you can call us at area code 859-748-9961. That's 859-748-9961. Be sure to order your copy of Stop Talking Crazy, Talk Love, which teaches you to use the power of your tongue with God's word to watch your life stay in overflow. Order your copy for a donation of any amount.
Praise the Lord, you stayed with me. I'm so excited because we get to talk more about how God wants us to talk, not only to each other, but to him especially. See, the Lord hears what we say. I like to teach people that God isn't deaf. He doesn't have to he doesn't have to be told things five times. It's all right to tell him things five times if that's what you want to do, but he doesn't have to be told things five times. In the name of Jesus, God wants your year. He wants your life. He wants your day. He wants everything about you to be successful and prosperous in every area of your life. And how you're talking is going to dictate what you're getting. if you're getting, if you look around your life, you'll probably be able to figure out that some of what you have, or most of what you have, is due to what you've been saying, not even to God. I mean, we're talking, when we're talking to other people, but see, the Lord is listening. The Lord is listening, and He knows. He says in Psalms 139, I know every word on your tongue before you speak. So when you talk, your voice, your sound of your voice, your expression of your voice, your tone and your words are what are in your heart. So when you speak, know that what's in your heart and your mind is coming out of your mouth. And if it's not an honor to God, and it's not an honor to you or other people, then it's not probably what God wants you to be saying. In the name of Jesus, let's look at 1 John 5:14-15. Speak this scripture out loud and say, and this is the confidence, the assurance, the privilege of boldness, which we have in Him, we are sure that if we ask anything, make any request according to His will in agreement with His own plan, He listens to and hears us. And since we positively know that He listens to us in whatever we ask, we also know with settled and absolute knowledge that we have granted us as our present possessions the requests made of Him. Now, you can't go asking God crazy stuff like kill that other woman that my husband's run off with, or God, let me help me rob this bank over here so I can have extra money. You can't ask God that kind of foolish. That's not what we're talking about. We're talking about praying and talking to God according to His word. See, when you read Psalms 23, when you say, the Lord is my shepherd, when you speak that out loud, oh God, thank you that you are my shepherd. Oh Lord, thank you that you lead me and guide me. When you speak Isaiah 54:13 over your children, and you say, Lord, I thank you that my children are all disciples taught by you, Lord, and great is the peace and the undisturbed composure of my children. When you speak those words, when you say that to God, He is obligated to perform His word. So what are you saying? How are you talking to God about your children? How are you talking to your children about your children? It just breaks my heart when I'm out in a store. My heart literally aches when I hear a parent look down at a child 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 years old and bitterly announce to them in public in a store, straighten up or I'll give you something to cry about. You're a bad child. Why don't you learn to be good? Honey, that kind of talk is encouraging bitterness in the child. It's destroying their spirit. It's an attack direct from the pit of hell on a child. And it just aches my heart when I hear that, because I know that your words are powerful. When you talk to your husband, your wife, when you talk to your boss, I have, unfortunately, the past experience of knowing that what I'm saying is correct. I have a daughter that's my firstborn, oldest daughter. She has a daughter now that's graduating, or not graduating, but in her second, third year of college, and she'll be getting married this summer. And I can remember, before I knew what I'm saying to you, I can remember saying to her things like, if you don't clean up your room, you're never going to be a good housekeeper when you get older. I remember saying things to her, why don't you straighten up? Why don't you learn to act right? Why don't you behave? Questions that put doubt and horrible attitudes into her precious mind. And we've worked all that out now. We've gone and talked it over, and we understand that is not how I should have talked to her as a young mother and as a young child. So I know from experience, honey, you've got to say what God would have you say. When we come back in a few minutes, We're going to talk about what Job said to the Lord. See, everybody thinks Job had nothing but a treacherous life, but that's not so. Job, God restored to Job double everything he lost. But Job had to say to the Lord and learn in his heart what to say before God could restore him. You may need restored today. You may need a blessing from God, but God is waiting on you. He's waiting on you to come to him and speak his words to him the way he wants his words spoken. So when we come back in the next few seconds, we're going to talk further about what Job did and how God was able to restore to him double all that he'd lost in the name of Jesus. I love you. See you in a minute.
It's a little book with a big message. Stop Talking Crazy, Talk Love will teach you to use the power of your tongue with God's word and watch your life stay in overflow. Order your copy today for a donation of any amount. And don't forget to request our free newsletter. Write to Rose Ministries, P.O. Box M, Bergen, Kentucky, 40310. That's Rose Ministries, P.O. Box M, Bergen, Kentucky, 40310. Or you can call us at area code 859-748-9961. That's 859-748-9961. Be sure to order your copy of Stop Talking Crazy, Talk Love, which teaches you to use the power of your tongue with God's word to watch your life stay in overflow. Order your copy for a donation of any amount.
God bless you for staying with me. I'm Rose with Clear Vision, and we are getting some clear vision here today on how to stop talking crazy. So this little book, Stop Talking Crazy, Talk Love, is for you. It's to teach you how to speak what God would have you speak so that you can be blessed by him. And this is not so God can be a Santa Claus to you or somebody you just run to and get everything you want. This is how you talk to God to honor him and bless him. See, we can be a blessing to God, and God wants us to be a blessing. We were talking a minute ago about Job, and what did Job say? What did Job have to learn in order to come before the Lord and receive double back for everything that he had lost? And it's all in Job 42. Then Job said to the Lord, well, let's back up into verse 34 at chapter 41 first. God is saying that he looks at mighty beasts of prey in the face without terror. He's a monarch over all the sons of pride. And now, Job, who are you who dares not arouse the unmastered crocodile, yet who dares resist me, the beast's creator, to my face? Everything under the heavens is mine, therefore, who can have a claim against God? You see, beloved, we forget we are created by the creator of this universe. We are the creation of Almighty God. And who are we to disagree that God wants us blessed? Who are we to disagree that God wants us prosperous in every way? Who are we? Who are you to decide that God is not healing you, or God is not healer, or he doesn't have healing for you? You are God's creation. So he says, he said this to Job, who can have a claim against God? And then Job said to the Lord, see, he's talking to God here. I know that you can do all things, and that no thought or purpose of yours can be restrained or thwarted. God's purpose and thought for you is for you to be blessed. Jabez knew enough about that he went before God and said, bless me, Lord. Prosper me. See, God wants you blessed and prosperous. He wants you to know that all things are possible with him. He wants you to know that believing demands simple action. God wants you to know that you sow when you speak His words, and He will honor His word. He will multiply and grow His word to a harvest. He can't grow your words that are not His words. He will not grow them. Thank goodness. Thank goodness that He won't. So Job says to the Lord, I know that you can do all things, and that no thought or purpose of yours can be restrained or thwarted. You said to me, who is this that darkens and obscures counsel by words without knowledge? Therefore, I now see. I have rashly uttered what I did not understand, things too wonderful for me which I did not know. That's why I want you to get this book, The 30 Days, The Champion in You, The Grand Champion in You, The 30 Days Devotion, because it's full of God's Word for you. It's full of God's Word to teach you things you do not know. See, God wants you to know Him. He wants you to know Him through His Word. And stop talking crazy. He wants you to be the grand champion that He created you to be. God says, call to me and I'll answer you. That's in Jeremiah. Call to me and I'll answer you. I always say that's a telephone number of God. It's Jeremiah 33:3. That's God's telephone number. Call to me and I'll answer you. See, God wants to answer you. But you have to call to Him the way He wants you to ask Him. In His Word. So Job says, no thought or purpose of yours can be restrained or thwarted. You said to me, who is this that darkens and obscures counsel by words without knowledge? Therefore, I now see I have rashly uttered what I did not understand, things too wonderful for me which I did not know. I had virtually said to you, what you have said to me, hear, I beseech you, and I will speak. I will demand of you, and you declare to me. Before I go on with the next verse, verse 5, I want you to understand, God wants you to require Him, expect Him to honor His word. God wants that. And then Job said the most amazing thing that we all need to say today. I had heard of you only by the hearing of the ear. But now my spiritual eye sees you. Therefore I loathe my words and abhor myself and repent in dust and ashes. In other words, Job said, I'm going to change my way of thinking. I'm going to change my way of acting, which will change my emotions, which will change my habits. Stay with me. I'm going to finish what Job had happened to him in just a minute. I love you. I'll be right back. And let's stop talking crazy. I'll see you in a minute. I love you.
It's a little book with a big message. Stop Talking Crazy, Talk Love will teach you to use the power of your tongue with God's word and watch your life stay in overflow. Order your copy today for a donation of any amount. And don't forget to request our free newsletter. Write to Rose Ministries, P.O. Box M, Bergen, Kentucky, 40310. That's Rose Ministries, P.O. Box M, Bergen, Kentucky, 40310. Or you can call us at area code 859-748-9961. That's 859-748-9961. Be sure to order your copy of Stop Talking Crazy, Talk Love, which teaches you to use the power of your tongue with God's Word to watch your life stay in overflow. Order your copy for a donation of any amount.
Praise the Lord, you've been with me, Rose, today with Clear Vision, and we're closing the program today. I want to encourage you, if you don't know the Lord, to pray this simple prayer with me. Say, Father, I thank you that I want to know you. Thank you, Lord, that you show yourself to me. God, please let Jesus be in my life. And I know that He's the Son of God. Thank you, Father, for that. It's just that simple, see? And then the Lord is in your heart forever, and you have eternity with Him. So thank you for praying that if you did. And I want to close with continuing and helping you finalize to understand your words are life and death. Learn to speak God's word. And if you can't say God's word, don't talk. Just don't talk till you can say what God says. Amen? The Lord had told Job that he wanted to know what he thought about him. God says, what do you think about me, Job? Who am I? Who am I? And Job said, I've heard about you, but now I've seen you. Have you seen the Lord today? Have you seen that with your spiritual eyes? Have you seen the God that loves you, that wants you blessed? Have you seen the God that wants you to say, dear Father, thank you for promising to restore me. Restore to me. Restore for me all that the enemy has stolen. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord, that you love me. Thank you, God, that you live for me and that I can live for you. Thank you, oh God, that you want me blessed. So, Lord, bless me. Bless me today. Lord, I pray for those that have harmed me. I thank you, Lord, that I'm forgiving of them. And, Lord, forgive me for anyone I've harmed in the name of Jesus. Forgive me. Lord, thank you that you forgive me. Thank you that you love me with all your strength. Thank you for keeping me and giving me favor today. Thank you for teaching me that I can stop talking crazy and I can talk love. See, God is love. That's who he is. He doesn't just have love. He doesn't just give love. He is that. And he's in you. So he's in you with that love. And he's ready for that love to pour out of you onto everything and everybody around you, including him. I love you so much. I thank you for staying with me today. And if you want to read more about Job, go into chapter 42 and read how he prayed for his friends and God restored him. I love you so much. Thank you for being with me. I look for you next time. And call the ministry and let me pray with you. Call the ministry and tell me you want to support the ministry. Thank you so much. This is Rose. I'll see you next time. God bless. Bye-bye.
This month's free offer is 30 Days the Champion in You. Do you want to experience the abundant, rich life in Jesus? As promised in John 10 and 10, this simple yet extremely effective daily devotional by Rose is a powerful tool to help you set your thoughts on victory. To the glory of God, God has promised to lead you in total victory as His grand champion in every area of your life.